back on the love seat. Still in love.
Hey, is this the same love seat or is this a different one?
No, it's a different different love seat.
Every week it's a different one.
Every week we try to get a new one.
Oh.
Welcome to Reign of the Chatelaine.
Our next episode.
What is our quest to make our house fashionable this episode?
Oh. On this episode, we are hanging a historic piece of artwork in our dining room.
Is it heavy?
It's a very heavy piece of work, artwork.
Oh, he forgot that in his first description of what we were doing.
I forgot to mention that to her that it was heavy.
I knew it was heavy.
But it's historic.
On this episode, we're going to a store called Vintage Soul Geek in Hamilton. Mm-hmm. We know Penny, and she provides the most curated collection of jewelry and vintage clothing.
Do I have to come?
You have to come. Do you know why?
Well, I thought I could stay and work.
I don't know that you work alone, Dan.
Oh, I could stay and do something else.
Maybe.
Okay, if you take me out for lunch, then I'll come with you.
Whatever, you can go out for lunch.
Okay, sounds good.
We're just...
So on the easel today is this beautiful painting that we got.
Do you know what it was a gift for? Do you remember the gift you gave me?
The gift of another year?
It was actually a gift of another year. It was for my birthday.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, a big birthday. And I got a big picture.
Oh.
Comes from a department store. One of my favorite stores, Winners.
Is that where that came from?
It came, yes.
And I got it for you for
birthday. Well, we were both there on my birthday. Okay. It's like a gift of you bringing me shopping.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
So we had this set up at one of our last houses, and when I took it down, I wrote down the measurements, the heights of which these need to be so that the couch can sit underneath of this. This will be the dining room eventually, but for right now, it's gonna be at the height of a couch. I've made a level line, and I put my two screws into the wall to mount the frame.
So even before we framed the put the drywall on, I think you've forgotten that you've put a system in behind so that you're...
When we frame this wall, or when we furred out this wall...
Furred it out.
Because there's, right about here, there's a slight bit of a chimney, so we brought this wall out so it's flush, so that we could put artwork on this wall. It's a very large wall. And we've taken some measurements of that framing so that we know when we hang the crest inside of this area on the wall, we know where the studs are.
So he's got a laser level going across to make sure that it's even. And then he called me downstairs to help him. And he's got the ladders all set up here. So we're
gonna put the screws in, we're gonna hang it up, and hopefully it ends up being level. I'm just going to take the picture of the back of the hooks of this so that you can see the photo.
So there are two hooks that we're going to try and get on these screws.
And the big thing on this is that we're not scraping the wall with our scraping the paint on our wall, because we're all painted and ready to go. It's not really like hanging a picture on the wall. This is a little bit more heavy duty. The frame probably weighs, I don't know, 20 pounds or
a little bit more than that.
50 pounds. Yeah, maybe 50 pounds. It's all stainless steel. Okay, so if you hold it, I can come closer and hold it by you. Okay, are you on? Or...
This is not 20 pounds, Dan.
Okay, 50 pounds?
No, I don't even think it's 50. I think it's 150.
Oh. So we got our frame up.
Okay.
Whew. There's no fighting involved.
No.
No cursing involved.
No. If that camera wasn't on.
Now we can start planning of how the magnificent piece of artwork is going to fit in this space. Anyway, you'll see that in a bit.
So we're just heading into Denninger's for some lunch. Denninger's is like, I think it's German, do you think, Dan?
Foods of the world, actually.
Well, foods of the world, right. It's sort of like an international food store, and they have like a hot deli counter little spot that you can sit and eat. It's on King Street in Hamilton.
Downtown Hamilton.
Downtown Hamilton. And so we're just heading in here for a quick bite to eat and then off to a couple other stores that we're interested in. Possibly, look at that one there, Dan. Vintage Soul Geek. I think I want to go there after lunch.
Great. I'm looking forward to that.
There you go, yeah. Yum. There's my mom's favorite. Merci. She only likes the milk chocolate.
More gummy bears?
More gummy bears. Oh, there's your favorite bars. The hazelnut, though, isn't it? That your favorite?
Mm-hmm.
Hazelnut. Oh, there's raisins in hazelnut.
Is that Maybe. A little snack there. Oh,
what's that? What's it right in front of you?
Is that the...
So we have the hot ones.
Oh, sorry, no.
Chicken and the pork schnitzel.
You want to split it? What do you want? Chicken schnitzel?
What about some...
That's what you want? Seriously?
We also have the sausage goulash.
Oh!
So what's sorry. In there in the goulash?
The sausages, different kind of sausages. It can be the Weisswurst, Oktoberfest. It's a mix of sausages with breakfast sausages and with some... red beans and some of like capsicum, green and red capsicum.
Okay.
Do you want the goulash?
No.
We can have the goulash. I would have the goulash.
You would like to have a sample?
Yes.
The goulash?
We would actually. Yes. There was someone in our life that when they were little, we would say, "Oh, just eat it up. It's goulash." And this kid would go crazy. She hated it. She hated goulash. When you said it, that's
it.
I know.
I like it.
So you're still measuring here, Dan?
I'm still measuring. So we know the height of the nail or screw that we need to mount our special piece of artwork in here. That is perfectly spaced top and bottom, side to side, within this frame. So I know the height. So now I've measured from the wall to give us center of our chandelier, center of this, and then I marked it. So then I double checked it within the inside of the frame. That was our mark, center of the chandelier. So then I measured evenly inside the frame and I got that mark. So I'm gonna go with that.
Are you following his explanation?
With our height,
mm-hmm.
to give us that mark exactly where the screw needs to go to hang our piece of art. That
okay.
should be perfectly centered within
okay.
this frame.
Does it get hung up with just one screw,
so
or
it
do
does
you
just get hung up with one screw? Ideally, I haven't checked my pictures from when we frame the wall to know that there's a stud behind here to give it a firm spot to hang on. I can't just put a plug in the wall with a screw because the artwork is heavier than the frame, so it needs a good solid large screw in the wall to hang on. And if I'm going to drill in here to see if I hit concrete chimney. If I do, then I'll use a tap con in the chimney.
Okay.
And that'll be perfect.
Okay. Okay, so we've got the tap con. Do you want to...
So, this is a tap con.
This is a tap con,
it's
yes.
Especially made to go into brick, concrete,
Mm-hmm. What makes it so special? Just the threading on it or something?
Yeah, the threading, the material, and with a specific size hammer drill.
Okay.
Or, sorry, concrete bit.
Concrete bit, yep.
Drill.
Yep.
Drill bit.
Drill bit, yep.
So I'm going to drill the hole, hopefully into the chimney, and then I'm going to screw that in and leave a little bit on there to hang our picture on it. So I got these washers with a small enough hole in them so that once we put this in, we're not counting on just the head of the
tapcon.
The screw to hold the wire coming up and wrapping around it to support our picture. This way with the washer, there'll be more support for that wire to hold on to. So now we're going to
tapcon it in.
I have a special little bit on the end of my gun that fits, that head fits into.
Well, there you go.
So that will be very sturdy. That's the ideal situation to go into. I say that now, but if my special piece of art is laying on the floor in the morning, I will be very upset.
Yes, yes.
So we're gonna suck it in until there's just enough room for that wire to go behind here.
Suck it in means to have it a little bit closer.
All right, we're gonna leave it right there.
Okay.
So now we got lots of room behind here to hang our wire on there to support the picture.
Yeah. Do you need to go and wash your hands before you don't get more?
Hopefully the work of art is going to cover this
little
here.
We've been in situations where we've had to pull plugs out of wall, not plugs, but the screw plugs out of walls and repair drywall because we have miscalculated a thing or two.
And if this is seen when the piece of artwork is hanging here, then we'll take it off and then we'll touch up the paint and then hang it back.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Let's just do a quick overview.
Looking forward to it. See you later. Enjoy yourselves here, folks. 25 to 50% off most of the shop. Only things that aren't on sale are gold. The sterling silver is 20%. And you don't know how much you save if you spin this wheel.
Oh,
are you okay that I film?
Yeah, for sure.
Can you just do that again?
What am I going to get here? 30% off. That's pretty good. Yeah, so just have a marvelous time.
Great.
I'm here for you.
You gotta
make it a little funny if you're something. When I have to let people know about our return policy, I always say, I was like, just so you know, folks, it's the worst return policy on earth. It's voted the worst year after year. It's final sale. And people are like, that's fine.
But it is what it is.
Yeah.
Anyway,
it's really nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you. What is your name?
Dean's a fantastic guy. Oh, I'm Nick.
Nick. And it's Kenny's daughter?
Yeah, Connie.
That's your wife? Yes. Well, Valentine's. Yeah. What will you do for?
Oh, nothing probably.
Well, maybe a little flat. Every day is love day. And you. Oh, nice. Nice.
Thank you.
cufflinks are a nice color. I don't know, I guess I just can't get enough of orange right now. I have these earrings here.
Oh, yeah,
yeah,
the ones that she makes.
Yeah.
She does really great work.
Yeah, she does.
We're very lucky to have her.
Well, I think she's lucky to have you guys. So. From what she says, she's right.
Yeah. Well, it's happy. Everyone plays their role.
Absolutely.
Everyone
absolutely. Role, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, we just do it.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, what am I going to get? 30%. Oh!
So we've now got our TapCon in the wall. It's perfectly centered within our square of our frame, stainless steel frame. And we're about to hang the artwork on the wall. So we're gonna hang it up, and then I will explain more about the artwork. But we're gonna get it in, get it safely hung up, and then we'll explain from there. Deep breath. Relax for a second.
I'm just going to get onto level ground and do some wrist exercises. I hope I haven't hurt my wrist.
I know what you're thinking. This historic piece of artwork is now safely hung on the wall.
Safely. Mm-hmm.
This is an old coat of arms of Canada. And in 1921, they changed the design to a different design. So this one is to be said to be 150 years old. It's all made of plaster. And it's on this red felted...
silk. I'm sure it's silk, Dan.
Cutout. And we mounted it on the wall. We also bought this silver stainless frame at an antique mall in Woodstock, Ontario. And it almost fit perfectly inside this frame. It just kind of...
It doesn't even almost fit perfectly. It fits perfectly, Dan.
Yes.
I remember the day that we bought the frame, mm-hmm. and how we had to race there in a snowstorm because you had seen it years before, and you just remembered about it one day, and you got off of work early, and we skedaddled on to Woodstock.
For a couple of years, I mentally had this in my
list,
my mental list. And then when we...
The list that's mental or the mental list? The mental don't list. Touch that.
And when I bought the Crest, I immediately thought of the stainless frame and how I thought it would fit perfectly inside of here. It's quite the piece of work, of art. Historic art.
Well, I think it's... It's historic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And heavy. So we also brought this to a almost like an antiques roadshow type.
An antique roadshow that was put on by a local art gallery, Glenhurst Art Gallery.
And I brought in experts from different fields, and I brought it in, and it was suggested that it used to hang in an armories building of some sort, government building, and... other than that, they didn't know too much more about it. I got a rough value of what it would be worth. But anyway, that's...
$1 million! So much is worth it, Dan. $1 million! Do the right... Do it, Dan. $1 million! It was not appraised at that. But in Dan's mind, that's how much it's worth.
Yeah. Look at it.
So I hope you enjoyed this episode. We got that historic piece of artwork hung on the wall with that nice stainless steel frame around it. And yes, it did turn out to be heavy. The picture itself was very heavy, and the stainless frame had to be at least 20 pounds.
Very heavy. Very heavy.
All in all, the two pieces probably weighed 150 pounds.
700 pounds.
Anyway,
700 pounds.
It has not fallen off the wall yet, so we think we're good. And where did we go with this episode?
I went to a store called Vintage Soul Geek.
Yes, and she took me out for lunch.
And we went to a Vintage Soul Geek.
Mm-hmm. I didn't find anything personally.
Oh, I did. Mm-hmm.
It was a nice store. The thing I liked best about that store was the music that they play in there. It's like kind of that 80s kind of vibe. I just sat there and downloaded all the songs that I liked as they came up.
There's a nice chair there, too.
It was a nice comfy chair.
Nice vintage chair.
Yeah, nice people behind the counter.
Yeah, fun yeah. spot.
Anyway, check them out. They post all the time their vintage souls.
Geeky,
but they're vintage souls.
Yeah.
On the next episode, we'll be hanging crown molding in the dining room, and you'll get to meet Karen, our new helper. Where are we going next episode?
We are going to a store called Candela.